while the black cat appears to be of great help. He also tends to lead Coraline into the Beldam's traps. The black cat leads Coraline back to the portal to the other world, causing her to disassociate again. So is the black cat helping or manipulating Coraline? The very end of the movie might provide an answer. After some adventuring, Coraline saves the ghosts by finding their eyes and destroying the Beldam's constructed world. She then throws the key to the other world, which represents her psyche, down the magical well she found while water witching. Coraline then happily goes back to her real world and tries to make the best of real life. Her family organizes a party in their garden, the same garden that was made to look like Coraline in the other world. As the view of the garden pans out, observant viewers might realize something odd. The garden is shaped like the face of the Beldam. While many viewers probably did not notice this almost subliminal tidbit, it has a heavy meaning. It represents the Beldam imprinting Coraline's forever, even if she was apparently defeated. In fact, was the Beldam truly defeated? Was Coraline actually manipulated by the cat? Was throwing the key to her psyche down the well a good move? Can the Beldam now trigger Coraline back into her world whenever she needs to? Like in other MK-themed movies, such as Labyrinth, while the final scene of the movie appears to be a celebration, the celebration is dampened by creepy little details that hint that all might not be well and good. The movie ends with the black cat magically disappearing behind a pole. Does the cat magically disappear because his job as a guide is complete? Or his job as a programmer is complete? It's not clear. In conclusion, while at first glance Coraline appears to be a cautionary tale about appreciating what you've got and not falling for things that are too good to be true, the movie's dark and twisted imagery hints to deeper concepts. The movie contains a wealth of subtle symbols that tell their own story, one that is laced with occultism and the dark process of monarch mind control. The entire movie is based on the symbolism of a menacing hand, representing the handler, manipulating a young girl, luring her into a world created to appeal to her psyche. When Coraline escapes, disassociates, to the other world, the concept of buttons replacing eyes represent the illusionary nature of this world and the blindness of those trapped in it. In the end, Coraline appears to vanquish her foe, but as subtle symbolism suggests, she might have simply done exactly what was expected from her all along. This movie, which features visuals based on the comforting feel of arts and crafts, nevertheless alludes to mind control, the most sadistic practice known to man. In short, it is deception at its finest, as it is the case with many other works in mass media. Coraline's hidden meaning can only be understood by those who have eyes to see. Unfortunately, most people still have buttons.